In this problem, we have a binary liquid and vapor liquid equilibrium, and it's helpful to look at a diagram, and let's look at the simplest case, an ideal solution. The conclusion should be the same. We're looking at pressure versus X1 or XA and YA. And it says we're at a point where YA is twice XA. So here, it's liquid, low pressure is vapor. And so the YA value, since this plot is corresponds pressure versus YA and pressure versus XA here. So I picked a point where YA is about twice XA. And it says we have 10 times as many moles in the vapor phase. 10 times as many moles in the vapor phase. So that means our actual starting condition is here, close to the vapor phase. And lever roll would tell us that we're very, you know, more than 90% of the way across between the liquid and the vapor. Now we're going to push down the piston to the volume is half its value. Temperature's constant, and this plot is for constant temperature. We increase the pressure and we decrease the volume. We move up to some point, for example, here, and volume is occupied mainly by the gas, so it's a pretty good approximation. 10 times as many moles in the vapor phase means volume-wise is almost all vapor, so we go to about half of that. So we go to a point where we expect we have half vapor and half liquid, our final condition. And so it says what happens, the pressure increases. We still have two phases. Because the volume is so large, we must have vapor and liquid. And the compositions change, so we're now at the higher pressure. This says XA increased and YA increased. And obviously we have more liquid. From the lever rule, our final point is closer to the liquid side, certainly not drawn very well to scale. More liquid and less vapor.